beautiful and moving way to commemorate dear Linda for her wonderful life of caring service for patients, for family, for friends, for so many over the course of her lifetime. Thank you very much, ladies, for the beautiful job you did there. That was outstanding. Well, to all of you again, heartfelt prayers and condolences. We gather here with gratitude in our hearts for the life, the love, the witness of Linda, for her presence within your lives. Throughout our funeral liturgy, we'll have different moments for standing, sitting, kneeling as you're able, singing as you're comfortable. We've probably been at funerals before, but I'll give different promptings just to help us along in our service. But thank you again for your time and your presence for being with us today. With hope and confidence and resurrection of new life for Linda and one day for each and every one of us, I invite you to please rise at this time as we begin our time in prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Linda Marie Kosloski died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. I'll sprinkle her very beautiful casket here with the symbolic white rose atop with holy water. A reminder of her baptism, being drawn into the family of Christ so many years ago. As you're able, I invite you to join us in the blue hymnals in front of you. Page 539, I Want to Walk as a Child of the Light, 593. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite you to be seated for our liturgy of the word. Those who will be helping with the readings can come forward.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. Who can find a woman of worth? Far beyond jewels is her value. Her husband trusts her judgment. He does not lack income. She brings him profit, not loss, all the days of her life. She seeks out wool and flax and weaves with skillful hands. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. She is clothed with strength and dignity and laughs at the days to come. She opens her mouth in wisdom. Kind instruction is on her tongue. She watches over the affairs of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her blessed. Her husband, too, praises her. Many are the women of proven worth, but you have excelled them all. Charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting. A woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Acclaim her for the work of her hands, and let the deeds praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Through all patience and teaching. For I am ready, I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Together, let us stand to greet the Holy Gospel.
Jesus said, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. For although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You may be seated. Well, again, first and foremost to you, the dear family, the children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, all those who are gathered here, those who knew and loved and cared for Linda here this side of heaven, our prayers and condolences are with you. Even more so is that great grace and mercy of the Lord, as we sang about there with the choir solo group, as Dr. Rayer, Director of Music and Liturgy, was leading us in that responsorial psalm of Eagle's Wings, that great song of great comfort, as we hear about being taken in the refuge of God's almighty wings to care for us as a bird does for its little ones. Indeed, God cares for each and every one of us with a tender care and concern, much as Linda did over the course of her life with so many little ones in her life. We ourselves have wonderful scripture passages to reflect upon. Thank you to our readers for doing a phenomenal job of proclaiming God's word today. In that first reading, we had that description there of, if you want to say it, the ideal woman, woman of great faith, of great industriousness, great perseverance, cheerfulness. I mean, do we need a greater descriptor of Linda? I mean, so really it lines up so well with who she was and how she lived. A wonderful example for so many of us. So we thank God that she was resonant with that. She was a woman of great faith. She's someone who really gave her heart to Jesus over and over again for the sake of her family, for the sake of her community, and then she received from the fullness of God's grace. She's someone who also resonated there with that second reading we heard of St. Paul's letter to his friend Timothy. As we heard there about fighting the good fight or finishing the race, competing well, keeping the faith. Even in her latter years as her memory was fading, nonetheless her heart still retained that sense of that faith that was instilled within her so many years ago. Right? Exactly. She's someone who really lived out that faith in such a simple, such a wonderful way. Whether it was her special friendship with Virgil, or was her involvement here in the community as a nurse in so many different ways. I don't want to steal any thunder from the family. We'll hear from the family after communion. And even right now, about how Linda did such a beautiful job in her family, in her work, and all that she was and did. But something to reflect upon, we heard Deacon Steve within the gospel there, that passage from Matthew about Jesus saying, "Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest." Certainly after her lifetime of working and caring for others, Linda deserved a time of rest. And so we ourselves look forward to that day that we ourselves will have that opportunity to rest in the goodness, the mercy of the Lord under the shadow of his wings in the heavenly kingdom. But in the meantime, we keep pressing on. We ourselves keep fighting the good fight. We ourselves walk as children of the light, as we heard in that opening hymn. We ask for God's grace to help us to shine that light of Christ, that symbol of light, which we had within that opening ceremony with the nurses who were here. A wonderful reminder for us, since within our baptism, our parents and godparents receive that little light, which is symbolic of the light of Christ. And here within our funeral liturgies, just beyond dear Linda's casket there, is the Easter candle, which is a representation of the light of Christ, which shines forth in those darkest moments of our lives with his light to help us. Linda was someone who reflected that light by her very namesake. That's what her middle name, Marie, means. It's a French derivation of the name of Mary. It means the star of the sea. And so in the sea of the world, she's someone who shined that light of Christ for others. Her first name of Linda is one which means one who is pretty, one who is beautiful. Certainly, she had that at the exterior level, but also that interior level of faith. Someone who had that radiated that beauty of the Lord within her life, much like a light shining forth. And so we ourselves thank God for this wonderful light, this wonderful woman, this mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, this nurse, this person who cared for so many. We ourselves press onward in this life, looking forward to being in that realm of eternal light with Jesus our Savior, with dear Linda and all who have gone before us, that we'd be able to praise God in his grace and mercy there forever and ever.
Amen.
God bless you all. I invite you to please stand once again, and for those who will be reading the prayers of the faithful, I invite you forward at this time. We ourselves entrust our hearts, our lives, all that we are, think, sing, and do to Jesus as Linda did, that we ourselves would be filled with that peace and that joy of the Lord.
Our response will be, hear our prayer. For Linda, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our sister Linda, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we come before you this day with great gratitude within the depths of our hearts for the mercy of your Son, Jesus, he who is the light of the world. Thank you for sending forth your Holy Spirit to guide us in this journey of faith. On this day in particular, we thank you for the life and witness of Linda Marie. May she rest in your peace and goodness, and may we one day join her in your kingdom to praise you there forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite you to be seated for the preparation of the altar. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we've received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we've received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
I invite you to please stand once again and pray, my brothers and sisters, and my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Linda, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
time, otherwise you may be seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." His wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with this Holy Spirit may become one body, one Spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Bernard, our Bishop, Joseph and Michael, his assistants, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Linda Marie Kosloski, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who is united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Again, at the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Please kneel, otherwise you may be seated. We are coming to the moment of Holy Communion, along with Sandy, our sacristan, and Deacon Steve and I will be here in front, or Sandy will make her way around the church. We as Catholic Christians believe this is the body and blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus. If you're coming forward to receive Holy Communion, we just ask that you extend your hands as such. Otherwise, if you're another faith tradition or not prepared to receive Christ in Holy Communion, you can still come forward to receive a blessing by crossing your arms in front of you. All of us are gathered here with gratitude in our hearts for the life of dear Linda. Thank you, God, for her witness, and asking to one day join her in the heavenly kingdom. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let perpetual light shine upon her with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her with your saints forever, for you are merciful. There of the Ave Maria or Hail Mary in Latin from Jim Arcander and Dr. Ray, our Director of Music and Liturgy. Thank you. We now invite members of the family, those who will be offering the eulogy or words of remembrance, forward to the amble at this time.
Good morning. My name is Randy Kosloski. I'm Linda's son. On behalf of myself, my sister, my brother Brent, I want to thank all of you for being here today to celebrate my mother's life. My mother would be very happy and honored to see all you can make it here this morning for For her, it was family and friends who were the focus of her life. It was also your continued support, wishes, and prayers during the last year that was so valuable to her. Our mother is survived by three of her four children, her 11 grandchildren, one great-grandchild, as well as her siblings, relatives, and friends. Mom was a kind and loving person. She provided love and support to everyone she encountered. As her son, I feel like I grew up with the most incredible role model who taught me faith in God, confidence in myself, and to always push myself harder. I will miss her smile, her laugh, her advice, and just spending time talking with her. She had many roles in her life, and I wanted to focus on just a few of those today. She was a wife and a mother of four. In her role, she was always compassionate and nurturing. We could always feel mom's love were with her. One of the ways she reflected that love was in her cooking. She was an amazing cook and baked sweets almost every day when I was a kid. I think we all lost weight when we finally moved out. She was a nurse, as you heard earlier, going to and completing a program at VOTEC to become a nurse. By the time I can recall, she had already quit that career to become a mother and raise a family of four. I was told she quit after her youngest Brent was born. Even though she gave up her career to raise her kids, she never expressed any regret. She loved being a mom and put her all into it. I don't believe she would have traded that role for anything in the world. She was an avid volunteer, both here at Immaculate Conception as well as Valley View Elementary, where all her children went to school at one point. Many a child learned and improved their reading skills with my mother's help, and she was recognized there for her many years of service and dedication. Mom loved to garden, and I remember spending weeks in the summer at the cabin picking and canning vegetables. Once Mom had canned all she wanted and put up enough pickles, my dad loved those, she would let us sell the rest at a roadside vegetable stand. The proceeds of that vegetable stand would pay for our annual family trip to the Minnesota State Fair. I think the fair was probably a little cheaper back then, but it was always a great time for everyone. I'd be remiss today to not say a few words about my mother's faith. I had occasion to talk to her about her own faith several times over the years. Always when we talked, I'd be amazed in her faith, in Jesus and the resurrection. She knew she would go to heaven, be with Jesus and the loved one she had lost over the years. At this time, knowing her strong faith provides great solace for me. I know the Lord has welcomed another worthy soul to his kingdom, and I rejoice even while I mourn the loss of somebody I love beyond all description. The last time I saw my mom, I told her it was okay if she wanted to leave us to Jesus, my father, brother, her parents, and all the others who she had loved and lost over the years. I know my mom hurt me and decided to make that choice. Thank you.
What a wonderful reflection about your dear mom, and such an incredible and inspiring woman of faith, a woman who loved her family and friends and cared for so many. Thank you. Just outstanding. Well, as one family of that same faith that Linda had, I invite you to please stand for one final time this morning and let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Linda may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
What's customary within our Catholic Christian funeral liturgies at the end of the Mass to have another time of holy water like I did at the beginning, or a brief moment of incense, and so we will be using incense. If you have an aversion to it, it'll just be for a moment, but it's very symbolic within the Psalms of the Old Testament. Says that as the smoke from the incense rises up, so too do our prayers rise up to God in heaven. So I'll be going to dear Linda's casket there, and then also symbolically incensing the Easter candle and the crucifix above. As I do so, Dr. Ray and our Scola group will be leading us in a farewell song, which you can join in, or this can just be a time of quiet and reflective prayer.
Thank you.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister, Linda Marie Kosloski, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Linda in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith. Until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our sister forever, we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Good to pray with all of you here this morning. Thank you again for being here. The family thanks you as well and invites you to the luncheon downstairs in Fellowship Hall. As you leave here, there's a stairwell you can walk down. Otherwise, there is an elevator if you prefer. There'll be a time for food and fellowship. Family's put together a wonderful slideshow of pictures of mom and grandma and great-grandma's life. So invite you to join us there. Just some words of gratitude to John, our sacristan, and Sandy, who helped out as well, Pete, our usher, Deacon Steve for helping as well, for Chris serving, Jim and Dr. Ray and our school group helping to lead us and lift up our hearts and voices in song. Thank you to our funeral home for your wonderful work with the family as well. We continue to pray for all of you, asking for God's grace and blessings upon you, that you yourselves would receive that light of Christ and continue to shine it as Linda did so beautifully. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest. Thanks be to God.